We would like to compute our reproduction number RT, and this means that we need to function rho tilde. Rho tilde is the convolution of rho EI and rho, so that means that we need these two probability densities. Rho EI contains the information about the incubation time, and rho contains information about the degree of infectivity during the infectious period. After a while, these two distributions are reasonably well known empirically. In this video, we'll see which distributions are chosen in the literature, and we will use these distributions to compute rho tilde. We will also compute the Laplace transform of rho tilde right away, because we will need it later on. So, remember what that we need. We need to compute our rho tilde, because in our formula for our reproduction number RT, with I new, so newly infectious people, and we also had our rho tilde of u. So we need that function first. And remember how it was defined? It was the convolution of two probability densities, rho v and rho ei of u minus v. So first we have to make some choice for those densities, and then we can compute our convolution. And then we can compute, finally, the Laplace transform, because we need that one later on. So let's put some ansatz, some information, what distributions are we going to use. Now, in the literature, usually exponential distributions are used for rho ei and rho a. And that is a bit odd. They are starting at highest point and then decreasing. So it basically means that you go right away, chance of going from exposed to infectious is biggest right away after the infection takes place. And that, for me, seems a bit counterintuitive. I would rather expect some distribution which is first low, then has some maximum, and then goes back, like some gamma type of distribution. So I would expect it's probably better not to take an exponential distribution for both of these probability densities, but take a gamma distribution in stats, so I put that below. Now, the computations are quite similar, both with gamma distribution or exponential distribution. So, in the remainder of this video, and also in the next one, I will use those exponential distributions because they are used in literature. Computations are a bit easier. But keep this in mind, actually, it might be necessary, if you really want to apply this, to generalize this a bit and to use this gamma distribution instead. For now, we'll use the exponential distribution. Then, computation of the convolution is easy, of course. So you have your rho ei of u minus v over here, and you multiply with your rho of v over there. And then you integrate with respect to v, which means that you can take this term which only has a u in front, so we take some of the constant rubbish in front of the integral, and you have just an exponential function, e to the power b1 minus b2 times v. So antiderivative is easy. It's 1 over b1 minus b2 times your exponential, so you have this additional factor, 1 over b1 minus b2. And in the boundaries, upper boundary gives you v equals u. So here you have your upper boundary. And your lower boundary gives you a 0. So it gives you e to the power 0 equals 1. It's the lower boundary, so you get a minus 1 over there. Then we can simplify a bit if you like by taking e to the power minus b1 u in, because that nicely cancels out this factor over here, becomes a bit more symmetric. So here you have your rho tilde of your convolution. Then later on we also need its Laplace transform. Fortunately, that is easy. You could even look it up in a table, but well, that's a bit silly. It's easy to compute, so that's for fun. Let's try to compute it. Our rho tilde of s. How do you compute it? It's your rho tilde times e to the power minus su, and integrate with respect to u. So you plug in your rho tilde, there it goes, times e to the power minus su. And the nice part is that you have just you can turn it into a single exponential. both of them. So there you go. Now, if you need for convergence, like that you have e to the power minus u. If you have something with e to the power minus u, if then u goes to infinity, it vanishes. So that means that this prefactor, like minus s minus b1, has to be negative. So minus s minus b1 has to be negative, or s plus b1 has to be positive. Same for s plus b2. Those two have to be positive, in condition which we'll encounter later on. Then the both upper boundaries vanish, both lower boundaries give 1. So what you end up with is a minus 1 over s plus b1 from the first lower boundary, 1 over s plus b2 from the other lower boundary. You can nicely combine those two fractions into one fraction. If you s plus b1 times s plus b2, first one gets a minus s plus b2, second one gets s plus b1. So what you're left with is b1 minus b2 in the numerator, which is cancelled out by this factor. So you finally are left with this nice, easy formula for the Laplace transform. So we have a nice rho tilde over here, not too difficult, and a nice Laplace transform. That is the advantage of using exponential distributions over here. If you would have used the gamma distributions over here, it's not such a big deal. Integrals become a bit more involved. You have to do some partial integrations, so the functional forms become a bit more difficult. However, you can still use the same procedure. You can generalize it, but keep in mind that you will get expressions which look a bit more complicated than this.